In the last 30 days, this faceless YouTube channel has made over $10,000 with only 51 AI-generated shortcut videos. This other channel, with only 115 videos uploaded, they have gained over 1.2 million subscribers. No voice, no camera, no on-screen personality, just simple shortcut videos made entirely with AI. No fancy editing, no big production team, just one smart AI tool and clever prompts that tap into what viewers love. You don't need to be a YouTube star to make serious money. You just need to understand the right AI tools and how to use them the right way. That's exactly what I will show you in this video. You've probably seen a number of tutorials showing you how to create videos like this, but let's be real, the final results? Not that impressive. So what's their actual secret? It comes down to two simple things: expertly engineered prompts and the right AI tool. Let's start things with the first and most important skill: writing expert level prompts. This is where most creators get it wrong. They just type in something basic like a cute cat dancing and the results are boring or off target. So how do you write better prompts? Let's take inspiration from the YouTube channel at MP Minds. They specialize in funny, dramatic, or heartwarming AI cat shorts. Things like a cat who gets rejected by a crush, a kitten trying to act tough, or a cat who becomes a superhero. And their videos get millions of views every single time. To match this storytelling style, we use prompts that follow a main story arc. Here is the formula you can steal. This is the prompt. In this opened and closed square brackets, you need to fill in the details based on the type of a story that you are creating. For example, when we fill in the blanks, it will look something like this: a fluffy yellow cat with big eyes, wearing, so these are the accessories, standing on top. This is the setting. This is the emotion it is reacting to after being rejected. After that, I'll paste in the simple prompt that says, build a 12-scene story with a sad ending. This story is told through images only, and hit enter. And just like that, you have 12 scenes you can use to build a complete story and upload it on a YouTube channel. Once ChatGPT has written down the scenes, the final thing is telling it to give you prompts that you can use to generate consistent images for the entire story. Make sure you go through these prompts and tweak them to match the mood of your story. But here is the tricky part. We won't stop there. Let's head over to Nim AI, where it gets even more interesting. There is a reason top creators are always one step ahead. They know what tools to use before everyone else. Right now, Nim is one of the powerful tools out there for AI-generated videos. You can create images, animations, video scenes, and even add sound and lip sync all in one place. And the best part, it works with 25 plus AI models, including Clean, Minimax, Google VO2, One 2.1, and more coming every month. You'll find the link in the description below. When you sign up with nim.video, this is their dashboard, easy to use interface. Let me walk you through the entire interface so that you can get the best out of Nim for your video production. When you come to create, you'll see a number of things that you can create or do using this platform. You can create images or videos, you can add sound, you can restyle videos, add keyframes, add slow motions, upscale your video, lip sync them, or describe, which allows you to upload an image and Nim will provide you with a prompt that you can use to create that exact image. When you come to explore, on this page, you'll see examples of what other creators are making. You can remix, analyze, or even reuse their project. For example, when we select this video, here on our left, we'll know that this was an image to video, and this was the model that was used to generate this video. This was the input image, and this was the input prompt used, and these were the negative prompts, the aspect ratio, the resolution, and the tags used. You can reuse this prompt and create your own video. Now, let's make our own viral cat videos. Whilst we are on create, this is the prompt box where we need to paste in our prompt. Now, to generate our images, what we're going to do is we'll go back to ChatGPT and we'll copy the first prompt for our first image. Come back to Nim. This is the prompt box. Here, what we want to do is paste in our prompt. Now, before we hit generate, there are a number of things that I want to show you. Number one, we can apply include our character reference. That's if we have an image we'd love to refer to. And on the pencil icon here, we can ask the AI tool to enhance our prompt. We can also add a number of things like the background movement, the lighting, the accent color, the style, even the camera movement and the facial expressions. These details are very important to enhance our image quality, mood, and a tone that we would love to achieve. Besides that, we have options to select between a video and an image. For now, I would love us to create an image and convert it into a video letter. From there, we can choose a different mode that we can use to create our image. We've got all these options from Flux Pro to GPT Image, up to Flux Uncensored. I'll select GPT image. From there, you can choose the aspect ratio for your image. Finally, we can choose the quality, high, medium, or low. You can try and check which one generates the best results for you. Once that is done, just hit generate. This is our first generated image, and this is our second generated image. From there, what we simply have to do is go back to ChatGPT, copy the second prompt for your second scene, paste the prompt there and hit create. Repeat the same process until all your images are generated. Once we are done generating our images, if you did not like the generated image, you can still regenerate, or if there is a specific emphasis you would love to add, you can still come to the edit button here, select it. From there, describe what you want to edit. In our case, we want our yellow fluffy cat to be wearing a tone blue t-shirt and the gray cat to wear something fancy like a white dress. Once that is done, just hit enter and this will be the results. Once you're happy with your generated images, it's time to convert them into videos. Just scroll your mouse and come to the image to video icon here, and from there you see your image selected. What you want to do is type in a prompt that is describing what is happening in your image. From there, what you want to do is select a model you would love to generate your video in. You have all these different options including clean 2.0. once selected, select the aspect ratio, and from there add negative prompts. Once that is done, just hit generate. From there, you can repeat the same process. Once your image is selected, just click on image to video, describe what you want to happen, select the camera angle and other facial expression, the speed and other settings together with the character's actions. Once selected, just click on the add button, select the duration, add negative prompts, select the model you would love to use, and once that is done, just hit generate. Repeat the same process for all the images that you have. Once our videos are generated, we can click on the download button, but before we do that, you can add some sounds to your video by clicking on the add sound here. We can also edit our clip. That's if our video is too long and would love to trim it a little bit. To add sound, just click on add sound. From there, describe the type of sound you'd love to add. Or just say some sound, violin and piano sounds. From there, you can select a model, though we only have one at the time of recording this video. Once selected, you can also add some negative prompts, but it's optional. I'll leave it just like that and hit generate. Okay, so that's the sound that has just been added. If you don't like it, you can use your own sound. Once all our images are animated, we download them to save them into our PC. Once all your video files are downloaded, open CapCut. Once it's open, just upload all your video files there. Once uploaded, begin assembling them in order. Start with the first video file. Once you are done, what you want to do is add some background music and some sound effects. I recommend places like YouTube Audio Library if you are looking for free background music and sound effects. And once adding sound effects and background music is done, it's time to add some effects to our video files. Just select your video, come to animation, and while its in is still selected, just select some fade in animation and adjust the duration to your preference. Once that is done, add some fade out animation as well. And do this for all the clips that you have. And once everything is done, let me show you how the final product looks. Oh. Okay, if you've enjoyed this video, consider subscribing because more value awaits you. Thank you, Nim.video, for sponsoring this video. If you want to learn more on creating animation, check out this next video that walks you through the entire process. From here, God bless you. See you.